Hello everybody, welcome back to Prince Persia The Forgotten Sands. I'm Nick Primer, and we are trying to catch up with Malik again, who's being kind of an ass. Sam. Is that not what I'm supposed to do? Am I just supposed to jump through this? Okay, it's a bit hard to tell how far away that is. What are these? Okay, those are spiky traps. Oh, what am I doing? I'm off to a brilliant start on this episode. Okay. I don't think I've ever tried attacking these. I wanted to see if I could mess that up. We got a rose window here. Down into a pool. I feel like it's time for another meeting with the djinn. The Royal Chimbos. Why is this the Royal Chambers? This looks like a baths more than a chambers. No, Malik, since you're being an ass, I don't feel guilty about smashing all your pots. Hello. Hello. Am I gonna have to climb around the outside here? That's kinda what it feels like. What about on the other side of this? There's just a few more pots, is it? Alright, so we got another reverse time. Then we go up. It's really quiet. Too quiet. Oh my gosh. This guy again.
Does he think I'm King Solomon?
Oh my gosh! We're probably not, like, helping him think otherwise. Oh! That way. And we are, like, stopping time, and, you know, buddy. Freezing water. Am I supposed to be- oh, okay. Yep.
Follow me.
That's an interesting conclusion. Hi. So another rose window. Oops. Do I really want to go down here? I mean, these guys are no trouble, but... I'm just saying, in the real world, if there's 200 enemies in the place, usually best to avoid that place. Most enemies in this game are just kind of a slight nuisance. Like, I'm not even bothering to worry about dodging very much or anything. There's definitely blue speckles in the air. So we now can do the increased damage of aerial slash attack. And then next time around we'll put one right here to add a sixth energy slot. So we can see what the other side has. Don't see any blue speckles. Ah!
Not again.
You know, buddy. What did I ever do to you? I just barely grabbed onto anything there. I know you're out there throwing fire, but let me crack those open for a second first. Where am I? Okay. Camera should probably not change angles right there. Oops. Aha. See, it's just like a rhythm you gotta get into. That worked out pretty well. Like I've said, I think I'm probably actually getting close to a third of the way through this game already. If not further along than that. I don't know, it's hard to gauge. I definitely hear something. Yep, oh, I saw it there for a second. See that? There's a... Nope. I was not trying to jump down there, I was trying to get up. Okay, fine. See if I care. Game. Have to remember to let go of the trigger. Okay. You know, if I had any control over the camera, I could have just looked over here to see that there was nothing. Oh, I do have control, just in the wrong direction. Excuse me. All the sand. This guy. You know. What are you laughing at? Jerk face. Oops. Ah. I don't really need have any reason to be cracking those open. Nope, go down this. Go. Go. What?
Where's he going? Malik. It's after his medallion. The throne room's in that direction. I have to get to Malik first.
Do we know that that's where Malik is going? Was I not paying enough attention? God damn it. Those still go off whether I hit them or not, apparently. Well, my aerial attacks are now more powerful. Well, what the sh- Okay. Glitches are fun. Stay away from fighting on the stairs. Hey. Mind of stabbing your friend in the chest. That was such a big windup. Okay, I hear another... It's up there. It's up above me. You know, your slashes don't have to be that, like, elaborate. I don't know what just happened there. I did not make that jump, but I don't know why. Okay, camera. Well, that was certainly happened. He stopped on the edge and then did it anyways. Oh, it stops that. Okay. Well, I don't know how to get that sarcophagus from here. So we're going to, damn it, let's... No, don't walk in here. This is quite the contraption.
Malik wrote to me about it. It's supposed to predict the future through the movement of the stars.
looks a little broken.
Somehow, I doubt it predicted the army.
Yep. Okay, now let me... Can I... Can I run through there? I'm gonna go with no. Can I look? If you would let me look. Because there's a bar over there. Oh, there's bricks over that thing. Okay. I did not see those bricks. I did not grab those bricks. There we go. Okay. Now we got enough for another upgrade, which means we can do this. And the last thing, damage caused by power attacks. I haven't really been using power attacks all that much. And we haven't also, we can also do this. Increases the amount of time you can undo using the power of time. And like the time, you can do the power. Double health. I have to do ones on either side of it in order to unlock it, is what I'm getting. No! I keep thinking A, but meaning to do right trigger. See, like I just did that. As I was saying, in the middle of saying it. Okay, well, we can progress now. That do? Oh, that breaks the whole thing, apparently.
Oh, perfect. Now Malik can kill me for treason and breaking his astrolabe.
Well, what'd you think you were doing?
Just pretend it wasn't me.
What?
No, I didn't touch it. It must have been the Sand Army.
Are you implying that he's gonna have more of a problem with you breaking the astrolabe? Like, I feel like he has bigger problems on his hands. What am I? Oh, damn it! No, come on. I need you to be faster. Like, who cares about the astrolabe at this point? It obviously doesn't work because... You know, the whole country got destroyed. So unless it predicted it. I mean, maybe it predicted that, anyways. That seems like a rather weird thing. Why throw that into the script? Maybe, I don't remember this game well enough. Maybe it actually has an impact on what happens. It's showing me what the hell this does, but it's not really... I think I'm supposed to be worrying about that other platform as well, that one right there. But it's not really giving me enough information. Oh, damn it, camera, what the fuck? I don't think I can get over into that. Oh, hey, there's another one on this side, I didn't notice that. I don't... Where did that even put that? Okay, now... Now I have a better idea of what I'm doing. The reason it's only showing me this one... is because that's all I need to worry about. Think. There we go. That looks right. So we now jump from there. Jump.
Somehow, I doubt this thing was intended as a mode of transportation.
Well, they sure laid it out weird if they didn't mean for you to do this. Like really, if it wasn't meant as a mode for transportation, then why have a lever at the top of it and levers all over the place that just move it bit by bit? Saying. Your line of dialogue doesn't really make a whole lot of sense there. Okay. Well, why did it...
Water must drive the machinery.
Gee, I think. Whoa. Why? I lined it all up and now it's moving. Oh my gosh! That did not give me long. I'm guessing this is what I'm supposed to do. Whoa! You acted like you were gonna grab onto it and then were like, nope, never mind. I didn't miss anything, did I? This is a giant, like, palace complex, man.
That's the throne room. Malik must be nearby.
I'm wondering if Assassin's Creed maybe didn't get started as, let's make Prince of Persia, but let's make it open world. Because, I mean, it's definitely like a spiritual successor of sorts to this. Little bit less linear platforming to it. And anymore, I don't think there's really any platforming in the series. They kind of seem to have stopped giving a crap about platforming. There's something going on in here. Oh, wait. What? Is that another one of those guys we've already fought? Or is this new? This is new, I think. It's a power attack against him. Jesus. Jesus. Hard to power attack when there's so many of these guys in the way. I need you all to die. Uh-oh, am I glitched? Well, I'm glad it broke out of that just in time for me to get hit. God damn it! God damn it! Come on, game! I don't know why the camera does that. I can't move. Can't even move. Can't even move, game. Can't even move. Can't even move. And I, like, had one fucking sand left. I could have used it, I guess, but... Just skip this. Give me a break. Give me a break, game! Yes! I can't... Alright, are you fucking kidding me, game? I can't fucking dodge that, and then you're stuck on the goddamn ground until you get hit. I don't know how this game has this bad of a camera. Like, the camera's perfectly fine everywhere else except on these enemies. This is really frustrating me, guys. I think this is gonna have to be where we call it quits for the episode. Why does the camera goddamn do that? Like, in the middle of my attempts to dodge out of the way, it's like, nope, we're just kidding. What? How am I supposed to dodge this guy? I don't understand how I'm supposed to dodge this guy. Cause look, every time he gets close... Yeah, we're gonna have to call it a wrap there. I can't do anything right now. I need to go take a break, collect myself, maybe start this game and restart it. So, thanks everybody for watching. Have a good day.